contender. His name is Sylvain Laborde. Originally from France, he comes from the German Sport University in Cologne.
He's come on his own, I think.
How long did it take you to train them? All right, there you go. Apparently, Zinedine Zidane has a lot to do with Sylvain's thesis because he has two PhDs, not just one. One was not enough. He needed a second one. The first one is sports sciences, and he tried to understand what led Zidane to act and getting mad during the game. And the second in psychology was to try to figure out how to limit Zidane to get mad the next time he sees Materazzi. As an Italian, French, I don't know. We'll let that one go. His favorite book is my favorite book, The Little Prince. So that made me feel special. And then we should call them both, him and Ashley, on the stage, because they are both singers, apparently. And I guess that we should call a certain point, but we'll limit that for later. And for now, Sylvain will talk to us about, I tell you, just turn the page. Ha. That was too easy. His study is titled Enhancing Cardiac Vagal Activity in Sports Psychology, Theoretical Rationale and Guidelines for Implementation in Applied Setting. Sylvain Laborde.
Grazie. 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 Come là? Come la porti? Già. Buonasera, Padova. So, you probably see the big horse behind me. I have a fun fact about this horse. Do you know that he has a resting heart rate between 28 and 40 beats per minute? In comparison to us humans, between 60 and 100 beats per minute. So, now if you like to give it a try, I will kindly ask you to take one hand and to put it on your chest. And you should feel something pulsing, perhaps something like this. Well, actually, this one you get only when you will come visit us in Cologne, because then we will see the Cathedral of Cologne, the dome, in your heart. So, tonight, I'm going to reveal you one of life's biggest secrets. It's about the brain and the heart. And more specifically, we will try to answer the question, are they best enemies or secret lovers? But before we go to the topic, I'd like to tell you a couple of details about how my research life started. So, did it look like this, like a little boy reading a lot of books? Not exactly. I was watching TV, and there's a specific day, specific evening. It was the 9th of July, 2006. I'm sure everyone can remember what they were doing on the 9th of July, 2006. Well, it was a warm summer evening, like tonight in Padova. And this evening, that was the final of the World Cup between France and Italy. 1-1, extra time, tension, and then this happened.
Alors on voit, voilà, Materazzi qui accroche Zidane. Zidane lui fait remarquer. Mais pourquoi? Mais pourquoi? Mais pourquoi?
Pourquoi? Why? Warum? Perché? Indeed, this question made me busy since the 9th of July 2006. So I started to investigate it. I went to Germany, And then I started to do a lot of experiments with students, interns, and it's a bit what our experiments look like in Cologne. So I needed, you can imagine, a lot of students and interns, and one, two, three, a lot. So it's also why, even currently, I'm a bit of lacking participants. So I just brought with me the form. It's in German, but if you like to do a Zidane internship with us in Cologne, then just sign your name, and then we will get it on track. So I wanted to give you some insights about what is to do research in psychophysiology. It often looks like with a lot of cables, so that my lab and office look sometimes like this. And I want to use those cables to study the heart on the one hand. So we use mobile ECG devices. And this is basically Maurizio Bertolo, our Congress organizer. Between you and me, the organization asked me to say that to get into the Science Slam tonight. The next part, with the brain, we do experiments with EEG. And as everyone knows, putting an EEG cap on you always puts you under your best light. So then we combine the heart and the brain, and we check the link relationship between those. And we get interested by this nerve, the vagus nerve. So basically, we can picture the vagus nerve like a cable going from your brain to your heart. And let's check what happened to Zinedine Zidane. Then we can assume that with Zinedine Zidane, this cable was almost deactivated, and they were at fighting. So like red zone, all right? And in order to understand this better, I thought about doing a live experiment with you tonight. So, basically, we are going to simulate the conditions of the final. There are plenty of Italian, French, and every nationality in the room. So, we are going to mirror the extreme fatigue, the stress, leading to this decreased self-control. Are you ready? So for those who like to participate to this life experiment, we can get standing. Only if you feel like it. And then we are going to start with the first task of today, okay? We start with some squats, so everyone stage. Rising up, back on the street. Excellent. So, for the second one, I think I need to take this out. Please close your eyes one moment. All right. So, the next one would be just if you have some space around you to do some jumping jacks. All right, very good. Excellent Padova tonight in the Palazzo della Regione. All right. Good job, everyone. So we have the pressure with the camera facing us, filming us. And we just managed, you can take a seat again, we just managed to get you in the red zone. And I'm wearing tonight my shirt, my Zidane shirt, as a heart rate variability sensor in it. And we will be able to see directly my heart rate variability on screen. It's quite low, so we're 10 out of 100. So what can we do against this, right? It's really time to investigate how to get it again to the green zone. So I got a couple of methods for you that you will be able to take home afterwards. The first one is the invasive stimulation of the vagus nerve. We're not going to do that tonight. The next one will lead us to rediscover some old secrets. And we are going to inspire ourselves from the work of the antique Chinese with their acupuncture and seeing how they stimulate the ear to provoke this stimulation of the vagus nerve. So we are going to stimulate it as well. Everyone takes one finger, is on or her own finger, ready? And we will place it into the center of our ear and just tap it for a while. And this will be the stimulation of the vagus nerve, normally with electricity. Okay, let's check what it did to my vagus nerve. And we just increased to 40 out of 100. We are getting there. For the second one, we have to go under the sea. And basically, we will use a mammalian reflex that every human has. And when I will put my head into this water basin filled with ice, with the help of the catering service, thank you, that will be a direct trigger for my vagus nerve. If you want to do it a bit with me, you can hold your breath with me. So the water temperature is 2 degrees. You ready? 3, 2, 1, and go. So, let's check what happened to my vagus nerve after this. We got to 60. All right, on the right track. The next activity I'm going to give you tonight is the following, is taking a deep breath. We will practice the so-called slow-paced breathing technique. So basically, you will have to follow this little ball that will create some oscillations in your heart rate that will stimulate your vagus nerve. So we're waiting for the little ball to go down, and when it will go up, you will inhale. Ready? Inhale. With the nose. And exhale. Next one, inhale. Exhale. We're doing last one. And exhale. Excellent. Let's check what happened to my heart. And we just got to 80, 80. We're almost there. So let's see what we can do to reach perhaps the 100. The vagus nerve is a social nerve. So when we feel lonely, then it has a very low activity. And to reactivate it, then we will need to have some social feeling. And one of the best ways to do that, we will use an icebreaker. And as an icebreaker, we will use the smile research of Tom Cruise and his team of researchers. So now I'm just asking you to smile to your neighbor on the right, to smile to your neighbor on the left. You can choose any of those smiles as an icebreaker. That's excellent. So, to complete this social effect of the vagus nerve, we know that we have to do something in synchronization. I know we already did sport together, so we will use other research on the vagus nerve, and we will try to perhaps sing together. All right. They told me they know how to sing in Padova. So, basically, you don't have... Do you know the words? You will just do la-la. I will play it a first time. Just checking the stone once more. Ready? So I play it once. Okay, no, sorry. I was not allowed to play this song tonight. We'll do another one. What can we do that could link the brain and the heart? I will teach you easy French tonight. So easy French goes like la la la. You're right, so perhaps... That's the la. La, 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 la. Je sens en moi la vie en rose. Let's check what happened to my vagus nerve. We're reaching the 100. So let's wrap it up. And here we visualize that the vagus nerve is actually our superhero of the night, connecting the brain and the heart. And for you to take home, just a recap of the different techniques that we used tonight. So with stimulation of the ear, putting your head into water, taking the breath, sing together, and you will leave Italy being more parasympathetic. Thank you for listening.
Now for our Science Slam Committee Q&A.
Sylvain, merci beaucoup.
Avec plaisir.
The last intervention of singing together, do you think that would be a new field for sports psychologists and an intervention that they should use with athletes?
Actually, that's very nice that you mentioned this, because there is some research about the national anthem that they may sing with the national teams, and there are some papers showing that when the team sings with more passion, some more, this will lead to better results. So we could extend this to the fan as well and to see how this influences the behavior of the team on the field. Indeed.
Actually, we don't really have many questions because I think the presentation was excellent. I just was wondering, because I always wanted to know, do you know what Materazzi told Zidane?
I'm looking to my French colleagues, so there are different theories about that. And actually, we should also ask the Italian colleagues about that. I think they are better placed than myself. So, some theories about some words about the sister of Zidane's mother. One interesting thing is that there was afterwards one encounter between Zidane and Materazzi, and apparently they cleared off things. I don't really know what this means, that they cleared off things.
But following on that, I mean, because I did watch that match as well, right? It's kind of unbelievable, because surely he's been in this situation before, he's played in Juventus before, so one wonder what the hell he was thinking about, right? He just scored the penalty. I mean, you would have won that if he has not messed around. So it's really, it's not the exception that would confirm all your work, actually? That,
indeed, we can say that it's an exception, but if we really dig into Zidane's career, that was not the first time he was reacting like this, and he was not also to get red cards quite often in moments where he shouldn't have got red cards, yeah. Like, for example, in the World Cup in 2002, one of the first game in the first round against Saudi Arabia, he gets a bit of a stupid red card, yeah.
That's okay. I mean, it's play for Madrid, so for me, it's good what happened to him, so.
Thank you. Round of applause for Sylvain, if that's the end of the questions.
Give it up.
Thank you very much.